A cycle of care analysis is a way to understand all of the stakeholders within a specific disease area. The way I do cycle of care analysis is to start with the patient. So you begin with their journey through their disease state. So who are the healthcare providers that they interact with? What are the diagnostic tests that they get done? Where are they seeing those providers? Who are they referred to? And then from there, what are their medical and then surgical options to treat the disease? How effective are those? And then moving on, who else is involved in that equation? So how is that patient treated throughout their disease state as they're trying to navigate the healthcare system? So you're looking for every person who touches the patient in some way or another, affects that patient's path through their disease state. As someone at a larger company, I have access to market research firms that I can use to do focus groups, that I can use to run surveys of physicians and key stakeholders within the entire cycle of care pathway. However, as an innovator, you probably don't have access to that. So my recommendation is to really start with the patient. Use patient forums and patient advocacy groups to get an understanding of how a patient sees their disease progression. And then from there, branch out. Go to each of the physicians that they see along their care site, the cycle of care, and to the nurses and to the providers, so to the hospitals or the healthcare systems that are providing care to them. And you can do this by going to national meetings where you can hear about the most recent research that's ongoing in that clinical area, meet surgeons. Often you can even contract with some firms to run a little survey at that meeting. And you can get some of the data that you're looking for to start to get a better and deeper understanding. Once you've identified all of the stakeholders in a cycle of care, you're going to need to go another level, be a little bit more thorough. So a physician is not a physician is not a physician. An academic surgeon sees all of the tertiary referrals versus a community physician is going to see a completely different patient set. So you need to understand the differences in the patients they see and in the variety of patient types that they see. The same thing goes for payers, hospitals, even the patients themselves. So it's important to outline an initial cycle of care, but then take it another level deeper in all of your interviews and all of your work. When you conduct a cycle of care analysis, you end up with a lot of information. This is interview data, this is survey data, and it can be overwhelming. And so one of the things that I try to do is just keep a source book. Every quote that you have, write it down, put it in a place where you can keep it, but then spend time developing the themes that you're beginning to see. Put those at the front of your document so that you can start to pull up the trends and the themes within the information that you're getting. The next thing you want to do is group your information by the stakeholder, and you may need to segment your stakeholders. The community physician and the academic physician are probably different stakeholders in your cycle of care. The moderate patient, mild to moderate patient versus the severe patient are probably different patients within your cycle of care. So you need to spend time drilling into each of the stakeholders and being able to divide the information by who they are.